Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to make for you a creamy roasted tomato soup, and it's easy and it's very quick and cheap. It's under, I guess, probably $10 to make this soup, and it makes about 6 servings. So what I have here is about 4 pounds of tomatoes that I'm going to wash and cut in half. I have some flat leaf parsley, and I'm going to use about 1/2 cup of that chopped, if that's going to go in at the end. I'm going to have one of these garden veggie bouillon cubes. These are healthy ones, no strange chemicals in these, or like MSG, things that are going to cause your body to have an inflammatory response. So that's one of the things that you need to watch out for whenever you're purchasing a vegetable bouillon cubes. I've got some basil, I've got some crushed red pepper, I've got an avocado, I've got some fresh garlic, some shiitake mushrooms. Some people don't like mushrooms. You can use whatever kind of mushrooms you want, or you can leave it out. This, you do not have to have mushrooms in this dish. I'm gonna have to use a stock pot. This is a 6-quart stock pot that I'm using. I love this pot. I have my garbage bowl so I don't make a bunch of mess when I'm chopping. I always use that. Sometimes I line it with one of those grocery bags so that my pan doesn't get really dirty, but I use this bowl whenever I am cooking. I've got my blender there, and I've got my baking sheet that I have lined with parchment paper so my tomatoes don't stick to the pan when they are roasting. And I am going to roast the tomatoes in a 400 degree oven for about 20-25 minutes until they start to get brown. I'm gonna peel the skin off, and then you'll see what I do next. Okay, so I've got my tomatoes all washed, and all I'm gonna do is cut the tomatoes in half and put them on the baking sheet. Okay, so I've gotten all of my tomatoes cut in half and laid open side down on the baking sheet. And some people, they put olive oil on their tomatoes, and you guys know I do not cook with oil, so I am not going to oil down these potatoes. These tomatoes. So I'm going to put them now in a 400 degree oven and cook them for 20 to 25 minutes until they start to brown and their skins start to look like they're going to come off. 400, and it's ready to go. Get these in the oven. All right, y'all, look good in there. And I'm gonna let it cook for 25 minutes. Okay, so I've got about 7 minutes before I need to check the tomatoes in the oven. And what I did in the meantime is chopped my vegetables. So I chopped the shiitake mushrooms, and I like the shiitake mushrooms because they have like a meaty consistency. So not only will the soup be creamy from the avocado that I'm going to put into the soup, but it will also have like a meaty texture, little pieces going throughout the soup. But like I said in the beginning, this is optional. Also, all of the ingredients and the instructions for this soup is going to be listed below. And also, there'll be a link to everything that I used to make the soup so that you can purchase it if you are in need of some of the ingredients, like the veggie bouillon cube. And I chopped the parsley. I've got 4 garlic cloves. You can use more, you can use less, you can use garlic powder instead. It just depends on what you're in the mood for. Sometimes what I do is I add fresh garlic and garlic powder, but I'm not going to do that in this soup. And then I've got my red peppers, and this here is just maybe about a little over 1/8 teaspoon, but you use your own judgment of how spicy you want things. I have a pretty big avocado. I'm going to use the whole thing. This is a really good avocado. It's nice and ripe. And this right here, I said I was going to use 1/2 tablespoon of basil, but I changed my mind and I'm going to use about 1 tablespoon of basil. And here is some vegan Parmesan cheese that I made. And I can't remember whether or not I made it out of cashews or walnuts. I'm not sure. But if anybody wants to know how to make vegan Parmesan cheese to sprinkle on top of their salads or soups, let me know in the description box and I will make a video showing you all how I make vegan Parmesan cheese. It's really good and it tastes just like Parmesan cheese. Anyway, so I'm getting ready to check the tomatoes and I'll show you what happens next. So I decided I was going to pre-cook the shiitake mushrooms, so I'm pouring some water in this pot and I'm going to water saute them. So I'm going to let this come to a simmer and I'm going to put the shiitake mushrooms in here and let them cook a little bit to soften up. That water is simmering. This is how you water saute. Everybody always asks me, well, how do you cook vegetables if you are not using oil? You can use vegetable broth, you can use water, you can use carrot juice, tomato juice, you can use whatever you want. Celery juice. I'm adding those to the pot. Turn this fire up on this stove a little bit as I try to get used to cooking on gas, which I love a whole lot more, but it is definitely different than cooking on a flat top, so I gotta get used to it. So I'm just gonna water saute this until they are soft. Okay, so you see how that water has cooked down? You can add more water if you need to. And they are cooked. So I'm gonna turn the fire down on the pot and then we'll see what happens next. Okay, y'all, let's see what they're looking like. Oh, yeah. You see the skins kind of ripping off of them? They look good. I'm going to leave them in there for another 5, 6, maybe 7 minutes so they can turn a little browner. Well, they're not brown at all, but so they can turn brown and see what happens. So they're not really brown. I think what I'm going to do is cook them for another 5 minutes. I want them to be brown. Seems like all of them are not quite the way I would like them to be. And I might turn up the fire in the stove another 25 degrees. I think that's what I'm gonna do. While I wait for the tomatoes to get finished, I'm just gonna add everything to the blender except for the tomatoes and the parsley. So these are the red pepper flakes. Add that. The garlic. Sorry if that hurt you guys' ear. The bouillon cube, the basil, and I'll wait for the tomatoes to get done and then I'm going to add those to the blender and then blend this all together smooth. One thing I forgot is to add something sweet to the tomatoes. You know how when you were a kid, I don't know, when I was a kid, my mother used to add sugar to her spaghetti sauce to balance out the acidity taste of the tomatoes? And I forgot all about that because you have to balance flavors when you're making soups. And I am going to add about a tablespoon of very raw honey. Manuka honey is probably the best honey you can buy. Next to that is a very good quality local honey where you can get it from the beekeeper yourself if you're comfortable with that. Other than that, I usually buy some type of organic variety from the grocery store. So I'm going to put a tablespoon into the blender. Okay, I didn't want to cook them any longer than 30 minutes because I didn't want to compromise the taste of the tomatoes. So I took them out even before all of them were brown. And what I'm going to do is remove the skins and add them to the blender. They look so good and they smell so good too. These tomatoes were very watery. That might be another reason why they didn't brown as fast as I wanted them to, but that's okay. We'll work with what we've got. The skin is off, and the skin comes right off very easy. You just take the fork and move the skin off. It's easier. This soup turns out better if you have heirloom tomatoes, but they didn't have any heirloom tomatoes in my grocery store this morning, so I got just the vine ripened tomatoes, and this is very difficult to do with one hand. So I'm gonna turn off the camera and take the rest of the skins off, and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, so I have gotten all the skins off of the tomatoes, and I'm going going to add them to the blender. And I decided I was going to add two more ingredients. I'll show you in just
a second. I think the soup is going to need a little more richness. So I'm going to add some tomato sauce and a little bit of tomato paste, about a quarter cup of tomato paste and about 12 ounces of tomato sauce. I'm adding both of these to the blender. So I'm adding tomato sauce to the blender. About a quarter cup of tomato paste to the blender. It's right there on the lower left side of the camera frame. And now I'm gonna add the tomatoes.
I'm gonna blend it until it's smooth, and then we're gonna add it to the pot. The only thing that's not in here is the parsley and the Parmesan cheese and the mushrooms that I sauteed earlier in the pot.
Y'all know I love my Vitamix for everything. I literally use it every single day. And I have an immersion blender, I have a food processor, but this takes the place of a lot of those things. Sometimes I have to pull out the food processor, but I love my Vitamix. Look how easy that was. I just dumped everything in the blender.
Okay, so it's all blended smooth. We're gonna add it to the pot and heat it through. It's so creamy, y'all. The only thing that I taste about this is that some people may need a little more salt. I don't add additional salt to my dishes, but if you're okay with salt, add your pink salt, your black salt, your Celtic sea salt, your mineral salt, whatever kind of salt you have except table salt, no table salt, to flavor this as much as you would like. I would also add to the top of the soup when I'm done some black cracked pepper on top to give it some additional crunch. Okay, so I'm adding the soup to the pot to heat it through. Smells really good, y'all. Okay, so I've started to stir in the parsley. Just gonna let this heat up and then I'm gonna serve it. This is actually gonna be breakfast for me. Well, it's about 1:19 in the afternoon, so I haven't eaten anything yet, so that's what this is gonna be. And I'm gonna have a simple salad with it. Okay, so here's what it looks like. Oh, it's so good and creamy. Crunchy, delicious. And remember, if you want to know how to make this Parmesan cheese recipe, let me know and I'll make a video. All right, y'all, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and also comment below and tell me what you'd do differently or if you're gonna try it. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to y'all soon. Take care.